Halloween is a fun time in many schools across the nation. Kids come to school dressed up, there's candy galore, and for a brief moment, there's a diversion from the urgency of our work to celebrate joyfully. But a recent story out of Middleton, Idaho has struck a very different tone. A group of teachers at Heights Elementary School dressed up as a border wall, complete with a Make America Great Again scrawled across it, with the Statue of Liberty and an eagle standing behind the wall. Another group of teachers then dressed up as Mexicans, with sombreros, ponchos, maracas, and fake mustaches. Pictures of these group costumes were posted to the Middleton, Idaho's Facebook page and quickly went viral. The pictures have since been taken down and replaced with an apology message from the Boise Area School District's superintendent. So, Manuel, as you can imagine, this has been met with widespread criticism. In the context of this very racially charged climate we are living in now, what's the significance of this?
I would change that racially charged environment to racist environment. First of all, the significance is great. I mean, I'm pleased to see that the uproar was loud. I mean, if you're watching this video, you've probably already seen stories about this post before even getting to our video, because this has been everywhere from CNN to all the local news outlets everywhere, the uproar over this, which is promising because, you know, part of me expected there to be a little more of a two-sided debate about whether or not they were serious and whether or not this was that big of a deal. But it looks like, for the most part, at least from what I'm seeing online, the lion's share of people are very much upset about this, rightfully so. But what I think this shows, you know, I've seen people posting about the percentage of students at that particular school, elementary school, that are Latino. And the thing about it is, I don't really care if there are very many students of color at that school, because it's not even about the fact that they did this having students in their own classes who might be of Mexican descent. It's not even about that. As bad as that would be, it's bad even for the white students there, because these are little kids, elementary school kids, who, especially if it were a school that hardly had any students of color, where are they learning about diversity? Where are they learning about representation of different groups? They look up at a teacher, and this teacher's wearing a poncho, a fake mustache, a sombrero, and these other teachers are dressed as a border wall. I mean, that's to say that's racist is almost an understatement. The thing about it is, when it comes to racist Halloween costumes, any culture that's used as a costume, that alone is a problem. Because no culture is something that, it's not a costume. You can't just take off your culture. You can't take off your being. You can't take off who you are. So for someone to don it during a Halloween, you know, celebration or whatever, and especially in such a racist depiction at that, is problematic in all sorts of ways. What do you think about this?
Yeah, I 100% agree. I'm really glad you made the point about, you know, on the one hand, like it just rubs in a nasty way if they're doing this in front of Mexican American or Latino students, but like, either way, it's shocking and offensive, period. Right. And part of the major problem we have right now, frankly, is a lack of awareness, a lack of empathy, a lack of consciousness, and just rampant hateful ignorance in the wide swaths of white America right now. And to see teachers who are supposed to be wiser and better and more informed and not woefully ignorant about these kinds of things, giving this sort of message in front of the classroom is just outrageous on its face, right? Now, some people might argue, well, you know, these pictures were put up on the district's Facebook page, so they weren't trying to keep it a secret, and they did it in a post that was talking very celebratory, in a very celebratory way about, like, you know, the great day we had, and it was like, you know, this cool thing we want to share with the world, right? So, of course, they didn't mean to be discriminatory by it. And you know what? I would say I'm not interested in that semantics debate with you. Like, it is objectively racist and offensive on its face. It is a tragedy for the students who must be in these folks' class. Because if this is what they're doing when they're celebrating, what are they doing when they're actually upset and angered? What are they doing in those moments when they're triggered by a student or by a student's family? Or they're hanging around other people who are, like, you know, more aggressively and violently bigoted, right? This is what they're doing when they're supposedly at their best. I don't want to see what they're doing the rest of the time. Folks who hold these kinds of viewpoints and behave in this way, I'm sorry to say, because I'm glad the district is investigating. I believe in due process. But someone who behaves this way, I think there's serious doubts about their fitness to be able to perform as an educator in an ethical and responsible manner at best. Right, at best. So the employees, as we understand it, as of November 3rd, have been placed on paid administrative leave pending the outcome of an investigation. And the superintendent did replace the pictures with a video of his personal testimony, apologizing and saying we can do better as a district. So, you know, I'm happy to see that, right? These are swift and appropriate first steps, but there's many more steps to go here, I think, to get to a place where we're not doing active harm by teaching hatred and bigotry or symbolizing hatred and bigotry to our students. Like, do they get the ridiculous irony of having the Statue of Liberty? Give me your, you know, your tired, huddled masses hiding behind Trump's ignorant, foolish, racist border wall. Like, do we have no sense of historical awareness, understanding? Like, it's just, it's hard for me to keep myself together and talk about this, frankly.
Right. Someone wrote to me on Twitter. They said, you know, this is a few individuals at the school. This doesn't reflect the neighboring communities. Doesn't reflect the state of Idaho. And I'm sure it doesn't reflect everybody in Idaho. And I'm sure it doesn't reflect everybody in the community. But it reflects enough people that this group of teachers could go on through their entire day dressed like this and pose like this and have it be posted, and nobody around like stop them and check them and say, no, you got to take that off right now because it's so offensive. Like, enough people saw that and kept on walking that, you know, it shows it does reflect at least a sizable share of people at that school or in that community. And that's a tremendous problem. And I can only imagine what their actual curriculum looks like. You know, with, you know, the school is 13%, according to the numbers we see online, 13% Latino students there. So I can imagine what kind of curriculum those that 13% of students are being subjected to. It also makes me wonder about the fact that some students, when they leave the house and go off to school, they come back in worse shape for that school experience, for seeing their teacher dressed in this traumatic, racist way. And, you know, I got to believe that some parents, you know, you send your kids off with the highest hopes and highest promise, highest expectations for them, and they come back having seen something like this and having received the message that they are outsiders and they are not welcome by these teachers, who, by the way, are incredibly political. People talk about not being political in the classroom. I think dressing up as a border wall and smiling in a picture is pretty much a political endorsement of that immigration stance. And I thought politics were supposed to stay out of the classroom, Jeff.
Yeah, of course. I tell you, you know, the Megyn Kelly story was big in the news recently as well, with her comments about blackface. And, you know, what really stood out to me about that story that I think has a very close parallel to this story is the comment she made about, you know, when I was a kid, it was cool. Nobody had a problem. It wasn't racist to be in blackface. And the question we need to be asking, you know, in as much as just being outraged at the statement is, you know, I believe her that when she was a kid in her community, it was fine.
In her community.
And the fact that we have communities like that, the fact that in Middleton, Idaho, in 2018, it's cool to dress in brownface as these caricaturized supposed Mexicans. It's cool to dress up as just a stupid symbol of outright hatred and bigotry, right? When you're an educator, right? And no one around them checked them on this, and the district put it on the Facebook page. Like, that's the real issue, right? It's the climate in which this is happening, where it's going unchecked, right? That's what we need to address. We have a ton of work to do. And, you know, I know there's a lot of folks out there doing good anti-racist work in all communities across this country. But when we see this kind of thing, like, these are the seeds of the more virulent and kind of oppressive things that we also saw recently in Pittsburgh and with the crazy bomber guy in Florida, right? Like, these things are not disconnected.
They're not. All right, people, chime in below. Let us know what you think. Check us out on AOTAshow.com and remember to like our page.